this dua of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of that which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam supplicated, that, oh Allah, bless us in the lands of Sham. And as I mentioned, Dimashq, capital Damascus, is at the forefront of the area of Sham. And without a doubt, this has manifested since early times. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent many companions. The famous companion Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who lived there, who taught there, who taught in the great masjids of Damascus. Great fuqaha and jurists have emerged from the Bilad al-Sham, from the lands of Syria and elsewhere. And, you know, one of the scholars said in the fourth century when he came to the famous masjid, we have the famous Jami' al-Umawi in Damascus. He went there and he said that every pillar in that masjid that I saw a sheikh teaching with students around him in the 4th century. This was how the area of Sham was, and specifically Damascus, Dimashq. And the famous masjid Jami' al-Umawi, which is present till today, alhamdulillah, great scholars are present there, people teach there. Great scholars have come in that area, and specifically in Damascus. We've had great scholars under the regime and under the supervision of the famous Nuruddin Zangi, rahimahullah wa radi anhu, the famous Amir of the Muslims, and his grave's there. People like Imam Ibn Asaakir, he's got a famous book, Tariq of Dimashq, many volumes in Arabic, where he mentions those people who came and lived and taught in Damascus. People like Hafiz al-Mizzi, Imam Ibn Kathir, who has the famous tafsir commentary of the Quran, Tafsir al-Quran al-Azim. And we have the Mufassirun of the Quran like Ibn Kathir, we have Muhaddithun like Ibn Asaakir, Ibn Rajab al Hanbali, and we have great fuqaha, great jurists who are from all schools of thought. Ibn Rajab al Hanbali was from the Hanbali madhab. We have great Maliki jurists who lived there. And the Shafi'i and the Hanafi madhab is very well represented, was represented, and is still represented in Syria. Great scholars. I mean, if you ask scholars and ulama and tullab and the students of knowledge anywhere in the world, subcontinent or anywhere, who is the greatest authority recently in the Hanafi madhab, whose book is considered to be the most authoritative work in the Hanafi school of thought, all of them will say that it's Imam Ibn Abidin radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him. His book Raddul Muhtar, famous book, commentary of Durrul Muhtar, written by Imam Al-Haskafi. Both these two imams lived and taught in Damascus in Syria. Both are buried there in the famous graveyard, Al-Babu Saghir. And so, and this book, his book Raddul Muhtar, even in the subcontinent, is considered to be one of the most, you know, authoritative book in the Hanafi madhab. And also, if you move away from Damascus, you go to Halab, people like Imam Al-Ghassani, who wrote Al-Bada'i al-Sana'i, famous book in the Hanafi madhab. Great scholars of the Hanafi madhab and also the Shafi'i madhab lived and taught in the area of Syria and in Sham. And even till today, alhamdulillah, for those who don't know, I was privileged and honored to spend a couple of years in Syria where I studied. We have great scholars there present right now. We have people like Sheikh Abdul Razak Al-Halabi, who is one of my teachers who I studied with, who still today teaches. He's in his 80s and he teaches books. The tafsir of Imam Al-Qurtubi, Radd Al-Muhtar, which is in 8 volumes daily. After Fajr, he comes, he teaches. Between Maghrib and Isha, he teaches. Students come and study by him. There are great scholars in the science of Tajweed and Qira'ah, where the same Sheikh Abdul Razak, for example, students come and study by him, who study and memorize the Quran, read and make the recitation of the Quran, and he gives ijazah, and that ijazah goes all the way back. This is the ijazah in the Quran, that you have, you know, recited your Quran by this sheikh, who recited this Quran to his sheikh, going all the way back to, you know, through the medium of people like Imam Al-Jazari and many others, to the companions Uthman bin Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, all the way to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through Jibreel alayhi salam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have a full chain of the Quran. Every book that is taught with a chain. This is a speciality, not just hadith, but Quran. You pick up any book, Aqidat al-Tahawiyah, for example, of Imam al-Tahawi. It's a book that the teacher will teach you, and he will give you a chain, a sanad, going back all the way to the author of the book. The Hanafi madhab, people will have ijazah and isnads and chains of transmission that goes from them all the way back to Imam Muhammad to Abu Yusuf, to Imam Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhum, and from Imam Abu Hanifa we know the chain which Dr. Akram mentioned to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So there is great blessing in that area till today. Of course it's not like how it was before, but that's everywhere. Even in the subcontinent it's not how it was like before. I will talk about the subcontinent as well inshallah before the next speaker. But I've been told to talk about the both areas where, alhamdulillah, great knowledge lies, the subcontinent as well as the lands of Sham and Syria. So this is where Imam Ibn Rajab al Hanbali was from, who wrote this book. He was originally from Baghdad and then he moved to Damascus and he taught there, and he used to reside in an area, teach in an area where it's called the Masjid of Sheikh Muhyiddin Ibn Arabi, the great Sheikh al-Akbar, they call him. Even till today, his masjid's there, his grave's there. There's a market they call Suq al-Jumu'ah. It's called Suq al-Jumu'ah because it opens on Friday. And there's a great masjid there which is Jami' al-Hanabila, which till today it's called Jami' al-Hanabila.